Are you ready? Okay, okay, yeah, let's do it. Okay. I didn't have to carry all of it, and I think that's part of what the journey is for Carol in this, is understanding that you can't, like, to change the world can never just be on one person. It takes everybody to play their part, and that's a huge part of what this story is about. That this concept that she's holding this mantle, that she is, you know, this the mighty Captain Marvel, is too much to carry. And so you realize that you need a lot of different people with special skill sets to come in and help get the job done.
Well, I think when we leave WandaVision and we see that there may be some tension between Carol and Monica, and so you see these two come together finally and deal with things like that. So that, I mean, that's a dynamic of how these three must.
Yeah. So that's a dynamic.
That's one dynamic that we can talk about or not talk about.
While Carol and Monica are having to find their relationship again after all this time apart, we have Miss Marvel, who idolizes Carol in the way that Monica used to when she was younger. So you have this, these two adults having to reconcile the relationship while this younger person is also having a relationship that mirrors the way Monica and Carol used to be together. So I find it really interesting, the three of them together and how they become a little bit of a sisterhood with their own, like, different points of view. So it's actually really nice and fun and very sweet watching them all work together.
I think she has certain expectations of what this teamwork should look like, and, you know, from the comics and all these stories that she hears about the Avengers, and so it's not exactly what she dreamed it was going to be. So I think Kamala's kind of the glue of the group and holds these guys together.
Do you know what you are?
I started during WandaVision, training with my trainer like twice a day, five times a week.
Ooh, girl.
I didn't, you know, you like, that is a job in and of itself. I'm sure Brie can speak to this, but it is, I was not prepared for what that took. Like the amount of massages that also needed to come with that, therapy, et cetera. But it was fun to push myself and my body further than I have ever been. And all of it was useless by the time I got to set, because that was a completely different set of muscles I needed to hang on wires upside down or whatever. So, but you know, I looked.
You're like literally using muscles you didn't even know existed.
Didn't know existed.
Insane. I was just watching and I was like, can you just hold yourself up more? And they're like,
can we?
My core.
You want me to be like basically be in a plank all day,
yeah, literally.
50 feet up in the air, and you're like, can you do it better? He's like, why don't you try?
He was the one who explained it to me. She's like, no, literally, I'm holding myself up by my core. Yeah. And I was like, oh, that sounds hard. So I'm almost like, can you cry from your left eye? And then also do the line backwards and upside down. And they're like,
and here's a new line. Can you say it like this?
Can you say it like that?
They want to spin you around. Okay, great. Thanks. Take two. Let's go.
The other thing about wires, too, is that it looks really fun and it looks really beautiful. And so people are like, forget. And then you're sitting there going like, yeah. And you don't want to make a big deal out of it. But it is, you know, uncomfortable, even though it looks cool.
I think it's fun. Painful, but fun.
That's true. You are great.
I love it. It's so much fun.
No, let me be clear. It is amazing and very, very, very exciting. But what's different with this movie from the first one is that Carol didn't fly until the end, so I didn't have as much wire work stuff. So this one, it was just like a whole new muscle group that was in pain.
She's flying everywhere. She's flying from the kitchen to the living room.
Which makes sense, because of course, it's like, if you could fly, why wouldn't you? Yeah. Like, you're not, why would I walk? I would fly. So it just, you know.
You're just hovering the whole movie. Yeah.
I'm just floating slightly above the ground the entire time.
Like many women around the world, watched Avengers Endgame and had that 6 seconds of all the Marvel women together. And I at once had like chills, but I also was very annoyed. I was like, 2 hours of this, please. So it was really nice that they decided to do a team-up movie with like three of my favorite heroes. So that's what was most exciting.
Don't worry.
She's got help.
I've been a huge Marvel fan for the longest time, loved the movies, and so I always knew I wanted to be a part of the universe. I mean, nothing's really surprising. Well, you know what surprised me? That Kevin Feige is like a good person. Because you always think like, okay, he like rules over this like entire empire. He must be like, you know, all my friends who are in the Marvel universe, I was like, just tell me he's a bad person, I won't take the movie. And they're like, no, he's kind of great actually and just really loves his job. And I was like, I mean, did that surprise you a little bit too?
Like, yeah, I thought I came on too strong. I definitely did. I gave him like a 5-page letter. Yeah, sure. I definitely did.
But you came on strong.
Really strong.
And it's lovely. It is lovely.
It was loving.
These,
it was caring.
It's all with love, yeah.
It's a lot when you're like, nice to meet you. Here's a 54-page letter.
About what you can do better.
He handled it really well and called me the next day over like Zoom and answered the first 40 questions out of like 72 or something. So wow. The fact that he like took the time to do that, and then every time we talk after that, he would answer a couple more. I think we're through the list now.
That's good.
No,
you had cornered him earlier.
When Sam Jackson was on set.
It's not over. It never
ends. We had some downtime and she opened up her notebook. I have some questions for you.
That was amazing. On Ms. Marvel, everyone was kind of new and figuring things out, and then you're like here working with Sam Jackson and Brie Larson and Teyonah Parris and Nia DaCosta, and it's like, it sounds very intimidating, but these guys made it very easy and were very welcoming. So, yeah,
it's
good vibes.
Very sweet.